Prometheus service discovery is the way to manage large fleets of Prometheus endpoints or targets. So if that's you, if you think you're going to be monitoring lots and lots of things in Prometheus, watch this video. It will save you a lot of heartache. Trust me. By the end of this video, you'll understand what Prometheus service discovery is, and we'll get into the hands-on. So you'll actually walk away with all of the code to achieve service discovery from both a flat JSON file and also an API endpoint that we will write in Python and FastAPI. First up, what is service discovery in Prometheus? Well, most of the tutorials and most of the way that you are going to start your Prometheus journey, you define your target statically in the Prometheus config. And that's fine for demos and localhost setups and things, but it doesn't scale very well. What if you've got 5 servers or 10 or 1,000 different servers, or you have something like a Kubernetes cluster and you're scraping the metrics from pods which die and come and go very, very quickly and dynamically. A human just can't keep up and stay on top of those endpoints. So we need some way to tell Prometheus to go and discover those. And that's exactly what service discovery is. So service discovery in Prometheus is basically telling Prometheus, okay, you don't need to know about the endpoints. Go look at this other thing, and it will tell you what the endpoints are. And then Prometheus just does what it's good at, which is scraping the metrics. This is, of course, much easier to see. So let's jump into a hands-on and I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so start by installing Python, of course, and then install the requirements, pip install -r requirements.txt. Now we're going to start 2 different Prometheus metrics servers. Both of them are running on an endpoint metrics 2, and that's just to show that we don't need to always run on the standard metrics endpoint. And they're only giving out 1 Prometheus metrics. If this line doesn't make any sense to you, watch my previous video where I walk through this and exactly what everything means. The important point here is that my metric is set to a value of 30. So let's start server 1 on port 9123, and let's start server 2, which is almost the same. The only difference is my first metric is set to a value of 50. Let's start that on a different port, 9125. So those are the servers that Prometheus is going to reach out and scrape. In a third terminal window, let's start Prometheus. Of course, you will have had to download the Prometheus binary, and I'll show you the Prometheus config file in a moment, but let's start that up. Go to localhost 9090, which of course is Prometheus, and go to status and then targets. So you should see 1 endpoint 9123, the server at 9123, the status should be up and it should be scraping. So let's just go to the graph and verify that it is actually pulling metrics in. We type my first metric and then hit execute. We should see a value of 30. Fabulous. How did that work? What's going on here? Well, the magic lies in 2 files. So let's start in the Prometheus YAML file. We start with a very aggressive scrape interval of 5 seconds just for this demo. The default is every minute. I would not recommend you have 5 seconds in production. And then, as you probably have already seen, we've got scrape configs, and this is where you would normally define your endpoint. So the magic happens here. We have a job name, and then we specify file_sd_configs. That's a special term. And then we give it a list of files and a refresh interval. So what's going on here? Well, here we are telling Prometheus not to look at its own config, but just look for a file in the same directory called targets.json and look at that file every 10 seconds and pull the targets from there rather than as normal in this config block. Then, of course, we have a magic label variable, which is starts with a double underscore. That's how you can kind of tell. And basically, it's just adding the instance as a label. So really, we need to look at the targets.json to see what's going on here. So this JSON format is specified by Prometheus. I haven't made this up. This is Prometheus giving us this syntax. We start with an array, and then inside the array we have a set of targets. And of course we've got a target here, which is our server. And then we another special label to override the default slash metrics to call it slash metrics 2. So remember, Prometheus is going to be looking at this file every 10 seconds. But remember, we have a second server that we're not yet monitoring or running on port 9125. So let's imagine our boss comes to us and says, please add another server in. Yep, boss, no problem. That's easy. Let's just copy, paste, and change that to 9125. Save the file. Notice I haven't touched anything else. I haven't restarted Prometheus or the web servers. Let's go back to targets. And after a few seconds, you'll see both servers are now up and they are scraping successfully. Let's go back to graph. And this is another cool thing. Because if you've got all of your graphs and things set up in Prometheus or another tool, the graphs will auto-update. You can see I've now got two different values and they're split automatically by the instance label. So if I go to graph, you can now see two separate lines on the chart. Basically, now your job as an SRE or a DevOps person is just to manage that JSON file. As long as that JSON file is up to date, all of Prometheus and all of your configuration and scraping is going to be up to date. It's very, very simple. Managing Prometheus targets via a flat file does, of course, work, as you've just seen, but it's not very user-friendly and it's not very scalable. So let's abstract that even further by using, this time, an API. Here I have a custom-written API that is returning a JSON to my users, and I've decided that whenever someone requests the slash targets URL, they get the response. Identical to the file JSON, we again have an array of targets and some labels that overrides the path onto metrics 2. And let's save that and start the target server. Notice the target server is running on port 8123. And now let's have a look at our Prometheus configuration for this. So this time, kind of same deal. We start with scrape configs. We've got a job name, but we've got http://sd/configs. With a URL to our target server, and we're telling Prometheus again, please reach out to this target server every 10 seconds to get the most up-to-date list of targets. Once again, we take the instance label, instance value, and apply it as a label in Prometheus. So let's start Prometheus with this configuration. Remember, our target server already has both web servers in there. So when I refresh the targets page, we've got two targets, the server on 9123 and the server on 9125. And of course, this is the job name, retrieve targets from API. You'll recognize that from the YAML file. Let's go back to graph and search for my metric. And we've got two results, both from the job retrieve targets from API, one with a value of 30, one with a value of 50. And of course, that will also work when you chart the metrics. Now, as a bonus, let's imagine the boss came to us and says, we're decommissioning the 9123 server. We've got all of our dashboards, everything's set up, the monitoring is perfect, but how do we update things to just get rid of 9123? You say, okay, no worries, boss, that's easy. What you do to do that is leave everything running, and that's the main benefit here. Go to your target server or your file, I suppose. Save the targets list, and within 10 seconds, Prometheus is going to reach out and retrieve the valid targets. And so Prometheus is no longer going to see 9123 as a valid target. So there you are. A minute ago, 9123 had a value of 30, and then the data stopped because Prometheus stopped scraping it because we told Prometheus it was no longer a valid target. And we still got the data from 9125. Now let's imagine a colleague says, we've made a mistake. It wasn't 912, it was 9123, it was some other server. That's okay, we'll just go and add it back in. 9123, save. And within a few seconds, Remember that depends, the exact time depends on your scrape interval and the refresh interval that you're reaching out to the target server. So it could be a few minutes or hours in your case. That depends on your config YAML. But again, no restarts, nothing necessary. We've just got the metrics flowing back into Prometheus. Again, what happened? Prometheus is reaching out to this target's endpoint every 10 seconds. It saw that it had a new endpoint, and then we told Prometheus to scrape those entities, those endpoints, those targets, every 5 seconds. So within about 15 seconds, we've got the new data coming back in. There you go, two ways to do service discovery in Prometheus, either via a flat file or via an API endpoint. And of course, there are lots and lots of other service discovery mechanisms that Prometheus offers, links down below. If you found this video useful, please, please do like and hit subscribe. It does wonders for the algorithm, and I'd really, really appreciate it. So until next time, enjoy Prometheus, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye.